What is going on, everybody? It's Crazy Man here, and I am back and bringing you how to beat Chaos. Now, the first step is to make sure the Chaos player isn't playing. That always helps. Look at those little heretics pointing their guns around. No, but seriously, this guy, this was a pretty good battle. He's eventually going to start playing, believe me. And, wait for it. There he goes. And, one of the matchups I see a lot of people having troubles with, even random people, is Eldar versus Chaos. And this is even better, because it's the Chaos Lord. And what you need to do as an Eldar against Chaos is quite simple. And yet everyone overlooks it, myself included most of sometimes. And I'm sitting there and I'm like, how is this guy just constantly stomping me? Well, first thing you do, you notice my build here. I'm going for Banshees and a Guardian. I know he's Chaos. Okay, this guy is a rank 60 Chaos, over 200 games, 230 games, I believe, at the time played. He kind of knows what he's doing. Okay, he's got his own little strategy. But he's going to make a bunch of key mistakes in this game. First of all, he's going to Chaos Space Marine, which I know people are like, he's a noob, he should go to Heretics. Well, if you went to Heretics, then you'd see why that would not work. Because his one heretic squad he has, needless to say, they don't last very long, and that's the key right there. Battle equipment, and now you guys are like, grenades. That's too easy. Yes, it is actually. It's very easy, and a lot of people overlook it. If he would have gone two heretics early on in this game, he would have been destroyed. Because I mean, nade placement is everything. Against heretics, a well-placed nade can destroy half a heretic squad. A very well-placed nade can pretty much take out a whole squad, and that's where the Banshees come in. And the Banshees are going to take grenade-friendly fire, so you know, you kind of have to be careful in that, you know, they're going to get slammed or whatever. But, actually, hang on a second, I better make sure I just toggle my settings here. Oh, let's watch this grenade fail really quick. Doop. Alright, I will be right back. I apologize. I need to make sure my mic isn't destroying itself. Alrighty, thanks to the power of editing, I am back. Actually, not even editing. Thanks to the power of clicking a button and to stop and start recording is whatever. So yeah, someone said in my last video, the reason I had to do that actually was because someone said in my last video I need to reduce the static, and that's something that's been bothering me as well, and one of the things that I think has been preventing me from becoming, you know, a bigger YouTuber is because people don't like static. So I'm going to be, in the next couple videos, checking around, playing with my settings, making sure that everything is good. Because the last thing I want is to record a whole video, just like I almost did here, and for it not to be good. However, fortunately for me, this time it seems to be pretty good. The static does not seem to be very loud. I don't know why there's static, to be honest. It's been there the whole time. But, you know, I'm not going to go out and buy another $60 headset just cut static. Sorry. Not making any YouTube money. You know, and I got a car to buy. Pay for. I actually bought it yesterday, so to speak, but now I owe $3,000, so that's always a good thing. But I'm really banking on this Diablo 3 Let's Play coming up 2 days from now. Happy Mother's Day, everybody. This is going up on Mother's Day. I'm going to be playing Crysis. And that's because my mother's not home. And I got a card around here somewhere, actually. Better, and watch this. Here we go. The nade, beautifully placed right in between the heretics and the noise marines. And there you can see, his heretics just got raffle stomped. Even with covering fire from these noise marines, and the noise marine's gonna lose a whole bunch of guys as well. However, the key to that battle, he is super fucking paranoid about defending this bottom point there, and this is what I'm talking about with this skill system being broken. This guy has 4,000 skill. Now you can't mean to tell me, I mean look at it, he still has the mindset. I can guarantee he has the mindset of I need to capture the victory points and I will dominate doing that. And that's a good way to drag the game on, but you're going to see in the end, it really doesn't matter. I mean, resources, I can just crank out unit, 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 bang. bang, 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 you know, and you can see I have a whole bunch of requisition. That's because I don't know what to spend it on. I have all this requisition, all this money, and I really don't know what to spend it on, so I start reinforcing my power node up here. Oh, spoiler, this actually becomes, like, my game winner. I know you guys are gonna be like, that power node did it? Yes! This power node does it. He starts running around, and it just starts spurting out electricity. Wouldn't that be cool? if you could get an upgrade for your power nodes to defend themselves. Like, I always thought the idea of shields would be cool. Like, shields on your generators. Oh god, voice crack. Drink some more of my Sunny Delight. Mm-hmm. And another tactic you can do with the Guardians, I just kind of did it there as well, but it didn't work, is you can use Fleet of Foot, F, and then you can G. You can F the G, that's what I say. But it's going to allow you to sprint, and then you're going to throw the grenade. You're going to have just enough energy to do it too, so... After that, you're kind of out of energy, but... You can see I get that triple power, triple generators on the node there, and here you can see... This is where the Noise Marines are ineffective, is on their own, because now they have to use their knockback. Yes, that is working, but just look at how much damage the Guardians are just constantly dishing out to these guys. And it really does hurt. Well, I mean, it hurts them. My guys are fine, but... Actually, no, they're not. I gotta retreat here. As Chaos Space Marine showed up, and the 2 Chaos Space Marine build is way, 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 way stronger than the 2 Heretic build. Especially against Eldar, because the 2 Chaos Space Marines, like I said, Heretics run up close, you throw an 8 at them, they're kind of done for. I mean, especially if you have your Banshees around. Chaos Space Marines, you have to run to get close to, then you have to throw the grenade at them, and then you have to hope the grenade hits, whereas with the Heretics, you're more likely to hit because you have your Banshees up there to kind of soak up the damage, if you will. That's a bad thing to say, because they have so light of armor. That's another thing I never understood. Why do Banshees have such light armor? Like, it's like they just threw on some red clothing just to match the army, and then just kind of ran out there and put their hair back in a ponytail or whatever it is, and... It's not really a ponytail. They just threw it all back. I never understood that myself, but I got the Shuriken Cannon on the Wraith Lord. This is the part where capturing all these resources that he's just now capturing. Starting to kick in a little bit. But look at that, it actually does zero damage. The only thing it does is knockback. So you can see he's got a blood crusher on there. And here I don't even want to show this just because I completely forget about her down there. And she ends up running into the base and getting shot. But she gets away. She gets away. We're good. Now you can see I'm building a Wraith Guard. This is where the Eldar shine. They shine in tier 2, and I probably should have gone for that Commander Snipe, but did not. The Eldar shine 100% in tier 2. And you can see, oh! Because of the Wraith Guard, units like the Wraith Guard. Look at the Wraith Lord sitting there turning around, and he's so confused. But, yes. My opponent is saving up. I know that you're all thinking, what the hell is he saving up for? He's saving up for the best unit, the best walker in the game, end of story, for sure. And one of the best units, actually the best unit for the price to performance ratio you're getting with that unit. And that is the Chaos Dreadnought with the claws, the dreaded claws. The blood claws, I call them, or OP claws. I call them OP because it's retarded. That you do, like, no damage to it whatsoever. And anyone who's faced them, who's faced a half-decent player... Hell, I've even done it in my videos where we're getting completely dominated and they have, like, 6 things. They have, like, 6 vehicles, like, 2 anti-vehicle infantry suppression team, and I just activate this guy and run him in there with his blood claws, and he causes a good distraction, but he eventually dies because it wears off, but it lasts so long. I mean, it lasts for a good 30 seconds to a minute, which I know people are gonna be like, looking at their clock like, that's not that long. That was like 4 seconds without me talking right there. So, I'm looking on a Ingraham clock. I call Ingraham. because that's, if you were to say that out, Ingraham, I need to get back to the game here. But now he's got his Chaos Dreadnought, he has the OP Claws on the way. And get these, hey, get them! You can see I'm already going tier 3. Just abusing the advantage that I have two fully upgraded power nodes, and I have this power node up here, which is constantly feeding me just plus 5. I don't want to upgrade that because that's kind of his side of the map, and you want to be smart about this stuff. Another topic. I know this is going to raise some questions from people. Reason I said the Chaos Lord was the best is because he has one piece of armor that can counter three races, at least. And he can counter Orcs, Tyranids, and Guardsmen. Guardsmen especially, and Tyranids second, and then Orcs the third. Orcs the third, but the Armor of the Inferno just, I mean, it just insta-knocks everything back, it sits them in fire, and they burn. And it's against Guardsmen. Have you seen fire against Guardsmen? That's not a good combination at all, but spoiler up here, I forget about one of my Guardian squads. I kind of feel bad about it. I'm going to feel really bad about it now that I'm actually watching it. It's these poor guys. They're almost level 2. I mean, oh, they're just going to stand there and get massacred. I'm not even going to watch. That's actually did get my anti-vehicle. I also got the Ghost Helm, which pretty much just insta-suppresses everything. Oh, they're all dead. But, almost managed to kill one of his, Whoa. This gaming mouse is not big enough, and it's, like, huge. And look at this. I mean, here we go. I got covering fire from the spirit, I was about to call you Spirit Guard for some reason. That'd be kind of a cooler name, in my opinion. Got covering fire from the Wraith Guard. And he took 200 damage, approximately. And he's gonna kill off my Wraith Lord. And it's still going. Look at that. How long? He activated that way back there, chased my freaking thing down, and like, oh, get out! And it's just time to call it in, Chief. So I'm building the Fire Prism, because Fire Prisms are very, very good. Not so good against Dreadnoughts, however, because, once again, you know, they're Dreadnoughts. I mean, you gotta make them just questionably overpowered. I have no idea why they did this, to be honest, but they did. It's kind of frustrating, Relic. Maybe release a patch so it, like, takes, like, minus 75% damage. I've stated this in other videos. Invulnerability in a game like this is what completely ruins it, because, I mean, a guy can just tech up, get some armor, and then, with the Hive Tyrant, I was playing with a guy, and he just kind of ran it into the enemy spawn, because it was invincible, and then he died, and just rebuilt him and did the same thing again, and it's like, what are you doing? Like, that was my mindset during that was, I have no idea what the hell this guy is doing. It's probably not very beneficial for the team, though. So me and the other guy on the team pretty much won us that game, but, I have yet to live comment. I'm probably not gonna be able to live com before, Diablo 3 comes out. So, I apologize for that, but, you know. I got Diablo 3-itis, bro. I'm actually waking up at 2:30 to 2:30 Monday night, and I have school the next day. 2:30 Monday morning. Sorry,
Monday night,
or 2:30 Tuesday morning. Jesus, 2:30 a.m. There we go. The day it's released. And why am I doing that? Because they did such a stupid release. Their release, they want it to be released for everyone at the same time. I have no idea why. So I'm what I'm thinking is a problem here is people could go to the store at midnight, buy the game. Something smells really good. Anyway, buy the game, go home, install it, and not be able to play it because the servers aren't up. I would be pissed. You could, I mean, I could go, I remember when they did StarCraft 2, you could go back and play that, so I don't know what the big deal is here, but, Avatar of Kahane on the way, biatches. Because he has to, Sorry, it was a long night last night, lots of Dota 2-ing. Actually, I shouldn't say lots. 74 minutes worth of Dota 2-ing. I went 12 and 12 with 27 assists. So it was a pretty good night. But I'm not sure if I'll bring you guys much Dota gameplay just cuz I don't know. Maybe I will. I had a 34 kill Death Prophet game somebody might want to see somewhere. But real quick, Fire Prism and Wraith Guard, really good combination because the Fire Prism does knockback to almost every infantry. And here you're going to see the Wraith Guard able to land a couple shots, and that's pretty much all his, all he wants. But as you can see, it's just not good against infantry. I mean, it's not good against infantry. So moving up, and watch this. It's really good against heretics. Watch this. Boom! Look at that. I mean, how much damage did they just take right there? And here we go with the invulnerability bullshit again. Look at that, one hit just took out 300 health. One hit. Come on, Relic. We can't have this happening. Oh, and he's got his noise marines over here for some odd-ass reason. I don't know why. And apparently they could still shoot even though they're facing the other way. Now they're gonna stun and... No, it's these guys. He's still shooting up here, so I'm like, oh, shit! You know, I got a Dreadnought in my base killing my commander, and I got the Avatar in there, and I'm, like, trying to get that Fire Prism away, and his Dreadnought eventually falls because the Avatar of Kane is, like, twice as expensive, and we have Covering Fire, but there you can see, down it goes. And here come the Plague Marines! No! Choof! Nice knockback there. And gonna be able to clean these guys up, or at least force the retreat. And I could have swore the Avatar had more health when he was initially launched. For some reason, I thought he had 8,000 health. You may call me crazy, but, actually, most people do call me crazy. But I could have swore he had 8,000 health. I kind of don't like that they toned down the health on all these units. I mean, they made it 20 less power, and they reduced the health by, like, 2,000. Like, oh man, that's not worth it at all. And the great unclean one. Don't even get me started with that guy. Most of the people I see use him, just run him into your spawn and then you just fucking kill him. Like that one match I had floated. I was dominating the... No. What did he throw in my spawn? I must be thinking of two different games, but I do believe this guy does splash damage here. Which is funny, because it looks like a lot of units do splash damage in this game then, and you're not, that's, it really wasn't evident right there, but you're gonna see right here. That guy starts on fire. And he starts on fire again! And them and their little axes. They don't stand much of a chance, but here, he actually made a big mistake. He got the Blastmaster. That's not good. Against the Wraith Guard, you want to keep their regular thing, because the Wraith Guard are obviously no good melee. Look at the Seer Council! That's right, I got a Seer Council. This is pretty much a really solid build, though, how to beat Chaos, and it all begins in Tier 1. And there's a nice little exploding gibbon bit for ya. But over here I killed off all his units, and he really didn't make use of his commander, so yeah, that might have been one of the reasons why he lost. But this is a pretty good strategy against the Chaos Lord, against the Plague Champion. I'm not sure. It depends. I mean, it really all depends, but this is how you're gonna... If you see a lot of players like this, which I'm sure people do, then that's a really good strategy on how to beat them. And it'll get you more wins. It's obviously not how to automatically beat them, but it's a great help. You just saw it there. I was able to beat a guy who had couple hundred wins is Chaos, so he's obviously not totally noobitis, but he did make some mistakes in that game that ended up costing the game. And apparently we didn't have a champion that game, which is, I kind of wish it would show that, even though it's blatantly obvious that I was the champion. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to leave a like rating, and yeah, we'll see you guys later. Happy Mother's Day. Give her a card or something. Go up to local Walmart and be like, I need a card because she's coming back in like 10 minutes, but see you later.